Crooker's Kingdom by Marty Ross. How much?
What's that?
Further. How much further, Richard?
Here, just along here.
Day like this, anniversary like this, I could be...
Yes, yes, moping around a graveyard. But even so...
Have you no thought of...
Of the children. 20 years dead and still chilling the air between us. How could I forget? But still, not forgetting, I wanted to...
To what, Richard?
I know nothing stands, not for long, however high and hard one builds.
What? What? Sit down, Richard, on these rocks. Catch your breath, you great fat...
Yeah, look, a man builds, achieves, well, a beauty even, once or twice, through blind accident. Yet the bricks crumble to dust at a careless touch. I know what we've lost, Margaret, for all that we've gained. All I've built for you.
Oh, yes, Richard. Let's hear again of the magnificence I've inspired you to.
Well, look, there, Cromford. A mill, a town where there was nothing. A wild rip in the landscape, bare rock, twisted trees, an ugly churn of river. A few huddled folk, stunted and stupid as wet sheep. And what was I when I stumbled here? A barber, weary of dyeing wigs in a Bolton back street, which left his wife as what?
As what? A happier woman, perhaps?
Happier?
Yes. Yes, happier than you noticed at the time.
Well, I wasn't happy. I needed more. Margaret, something to fight for, something to build, and I needed Cromford.
And my money to buy it for you.
Money well spent. Cromford is our child too, Margaret.
Only a man would mistake a factory for a child.
A factory and a town, and a life and a future for the hundreds my hard graft has brought here. If I've made mistakes, Margaret, I've buried them. Buried and built upon them. And I'm building still. It won't do, Margaret. You, my wife, living apart from me, making me look...
Like a man who can't quite conquer everything hereabouts.
Oh, I'll conquer you too, finally. Come, Margaret, over here, please.
That's enough, Richard. I'm going home.
No, wait, wait, wait. Look.
At what?
The tour.
What about it? There's nothing here. Yeah,
but there will be. It's just the spot. Look at the view. Down to the river and the town beyond. I'm going to build here, Margaret. A house. A house for us both. My wife won't shun life with me in this house. This won't be a house at all. This will be a castle. This will be.
What?
Well, why not? There are kings in this world who haven't made the money I've made. I saw them noble types sneer at me down London way day I got knighted. But up here, where the world's rougher hewn than me, a king's what I am. And being king, I'll build something even death can't tear down. Something so beautiful my own wife won't be able to say no to living with me. Of course, we'll need to dig foundations out of this ugly shelf of rock, but I know just the man... Margaret?
What?
Margaret?
I thought... I saw...
Saw what?
Over there, in the trees. What was that?
A bird. Heron, perhaps. They make a hell of a screech in the dark.
I thought for a moment it was...
A bird.
There's stories about this place, you know. My maid's full of them.
Yeah, I've heard the stories.
Stories of...
Yeah, I've heard. More relics of an old Cromford. A Cromford before I got my hands on it. Like the rock here, they can be cast aside if they get in the way.
It's getting dark, Richard, and cold. I'd like to start for home, if you don't mind.
What? So you can slam its door in me face all over again?
I'd close it quietly, if you'd finally admit defeat.
You know I'm not the man to do that. Not any count.
Somewhere in this world, Richard, there must be a door that would slam in your face so you'd accept it. Keep charging through the world like you do, and sooner or later you're bound to stumble upon it.
Nonsense. Even then I'll bounce back somehow or other. Yeah. Let's get you home.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.